this. Here's a headline from FoxNews.com, an American nightmare. Josh Napolitano wrote that about Trump ally Roger Stone's arrest. That's what he's calling an American nightmare. And the judge joins us now. Take me through the drama of the arrest and the raid. Go.
6 o'clock in the morning, 17 vehicles, sirens blaring and lights flashing, 29 FBI agents. The house abuts a canal, two boats in the canal, and a helicopter above with a high-powered rifle and high-powered spotlights. Four FBI agents banging at the door, two holding a battering ram, two pointing automatic weapons at Mr. Stone's head when he opens the door barefoot in shorts and a t-shirt. Now, this is not to arrest a kidnapper of babies or a terrorist. This is an American living in his home with his wife, who's hearing impaired and can't hear any of this because she has her ear aids out while she's asleep, obviously, and his dog. He happens to be Donald Trump's friend and advisor for 40 years. The charge is lying to Congress. It's not a violent crime. There's no evidence that he's going to flee. He doesn't have a valid passport. He's not an imminent danger to society.
Well, I don't know anything about Roger Stone's guilt or innocence.
Neither do I.
I don't even understand the charges against him. That's not the point. Why on earth would the government put on a show of force like that?
Either the government thought that it could intimidate Stone and he would flip and become a government witness against the President of the United States in order to avoid future treatment like this, or the government thought it could create an impression amongst the public that he's probably dangerous, which is why we have all this firepower to arrest him, and probably, therefore probably guilty. But if you think that my libertarian views are affecting my description of this, ask me what his bail was after he was delivered by these 29 agents to a federal courtroom.
What was his bail?
Zero.
What?
Zero.
That makes sense.
Zero. Judge said, just sign this, promise to show up. If you don't show up, we're going to need a bail of $250,000, but we trust you to show up. So the federal judge concluded this was preposterous for this type of a crime and this type of a background in this person.
Well, now we ought to know, we ought to be able to find out who authorized that excessive use of force.
That's a very good question. Senator Graham, Lindsey Graham, who's the chair of the Senate Judiciary Committee, has dispatched this investigators to find out. Did this come from Bob Mueller? Now, Bob Mueller can't tell FBI and U.S. Marshals how to conduct an arrest? Or did it come from the FBI field office in Miami, which is where most of these FBI agents came? You know what Stone told me off air? And I don't think he minds me saying this. I said, how did they treat you after the CNN cameras were off and while they were taking you from Fort Lauderdale to Miami? He said, gently, politely, and somewhat apologetic for what had just happened.
So, implication, it was staged.
It was staged. It's like the behavior of a police state charged with lying to Congress. They won't give him a transcript of his alleged lies because the testimony before Congress was classified. This is really Kafkaesque.
Yes.
That he should have to defend against something. The government has the paper that it claims contains his lies. He is not allowed to see that paper. The lawyers can see it in a secured facility. They can't get a copy of it. No way will a federal judge allow this to be the basis for the prosecution.
Good.
Because your friend, the Constitution, says you're entitled to be confronted with the evidence against you.
That's a remarkable story, Judge.
You can't make this up.
But thanks for bringing that to us.
You're welcome.
That should see the light of day.
Yeah.
It really should.
Yes.
Thanks, Judge. All right. One